All right, I'm doing a little bit of fuel pump diagnosis. This is a Mikuni. This is on a lot of the lawn mowers. Apparently, this puts out about 1 to 2, or functions, or meters out about 1 or 2, 2 or 3 PSI. I'm doing all this because of the ATV project that I've got. Their fuel pump also meters out about 2 to 3. So if these are working, it should work. But I don't think, I've got two right here and I don't think they're working. I've got two different symptoms going on. I'm in the process of breaking into this to see what's going on. So using my pressure gauge, it's not, this one's not holding any pressure when I put vacuum in at the pulse line, which a manual says that means that the diaphragm inside is busted. Although it does shoot out a little bit of pressure, this one, I'm also gonna break into it too, holds pressure, holds vacuum, but doesn't shoot out. It just, the gas keeps flowing out, in this one too. So something's going on with both of these. I wanna kinda break into them and see what's going on. That way too, I'll know that they don't work either. So I'm gonna try to do that here. Again, these are not serviceable, so unless you could cut it open and then reseal it. All right. Sealed really good. Add something to hold that down with. I'm just gonna crack it open. All right, I think this one's cracked up enough inside, or on the outside, to get in and see what's on the inside of it. Ow! There we go. Now there is a diaphragm in there. I can't guarantee that I didn't crack that, but it's dry rotted. So this probably was bad. That diaphragm probably was cracked. Let's see what's on this side. Yep. That's dry rotted too. That's wore out there. I know I didn't do that, so. Alright, I'm going to see, when I get into this one, I'm going to actually use the Dremel so I can try to get it out more in one piece. I can't find the Dremel right now, so let me see what happens with this. I guess I need to start checking these before I put them on to make sure they're actually working. Because with this one, the symptoms of this, again, it had really more restricted fuel flow. Oh, that hit me in the glasses. Didn't poke my eye out there. Cool. Now I realize I cut that right there. Thank you. So it has a plunger. So yeah, this makes sense. So this was the side where the pulse, and it's gonna suck in like that. So this actually was in good shape. This side was, at least. Seems to be real pliable. Doesn't tear easy. The other one did. So I want to see what's going on the other side now. I think I'm going to get the Dremel so I can make more of a precision cut. Really want to see what's going on over there. Alright, I found what I was looking for. Alright, got into it good. Alright. So trying to see which side is the in and which side is the out. See, so this one was over here. And it's going to push it down and it's going to come out. Oh, okay. See, we got a hole here. Okay, that's got to be the top over here, so it's going to push. That's going to stop. That's going to force that to open. Or when the vacuum's going to open that up. Close that. So the gas should come in here, and then I guess it would probably opens that up right there. There's no hole in between there, so somehow it, probably this chamber right here is where it meters it. So this one is a lot better shape, but like I said, it didn't meter out any more gas. I'm gonna see if I can find one that works now. Alright, let's check this one. This come off of a gravely walk behind. Hasn't been used in a while. This also is a Makuni. These things might actually go out more than what's suspected, for me at least. Maybe some of these pumps that go out is the cause of some of the pulsing that I see a lot. First, we're going to see if it holds the pressure at the pulse or the vacuum. Didn't seem like it's doing anything. I need to clean out the pump. Alright, after a prolonged experience with this thing, finally got it hooked up. Kind of messed this up a little bit, but it's enough. It will get some vacuum in there. You notice It seems like it is losing some pressure, but at least it's holding some. Just wondering if there's any kind of a pull. I don't know. We'll see what it does with some gas. I don't know on this one too. Gas just runs straight through it. And vacuum doesn't seem to do anything. This one's doing a little bit better using this one as the vacuum. This one would be going to the carburetor and this one would be from the tank. But it's just not pushing it up, pushing it out. Seems like there is some movement, so I'm going to take this one apart and see what's going on with it. This is an older style. Okay. This is one you can actually rebuild. I think the rebuild kit's really cheap. I might have rebuilt this one already. Trying to be real careful with it just because I might be able to try it again. Dirt in it, but overall it seems to be in better shape than some of these others. You got springs here and springs there. So looking at this one in particular, it doesn't have anything marked on it. So I'm going to take these springs out so I don't lose them. This one should be the vacuum. My guess would be that it comes in right here and then comes in through this hole, activating the vacuum pressure. Let's just see. Yeah. So that should be the vacuum. Looks like there's should be good seals there, so it still has good pliability. I'm gonna clean it up and see what happens. I don't know, still I can't figure it out. I don't see any arrows saying in or out, so I know this one fills up this bowl, and this one comes from the other bowl. So which one is the suction and which one is the, so this one has two, this comes straight from the port right here, and then that will come up into this right here. I don't know, we might just have to see what happens when we put some vacuum in it. I do know though that it's like this one had more, this is the one that had all the white deposits in there. Alright, it looks like we might have something that's somewhat working now. Got it hooked up to the bottom. This one, I'm saying, is going to go to the carburetor. It looks like it. Pulse. Now, I think this thing is very important. You know, I never really thought about it, but I think this is where the vacuum comes. Kind of like the air comes in. Actually, when I do my pump, we actually see gas come out, or should. Now, one thing to note too is that when this is below the gas tank, you know, you see the pumps usually on the tanks that are in the back. and they're above the gas tank. So when I take this off and I let it go low, then it starts somewhat draining. So that's just an idea. So I'm going to try the other ones now with it above the gas tank like that. All right, this is really interesting. Okay, what I did when I just put the phone down, I blew that out right there. So this right here is the key, apparently, for these pumps. Back in. That's actually some pretty good flow right there. Now, you know, we got a constant drip, which I think is a sign that a pump's going out. I don't know. My idea would be that it wouldn't have any fuel going through. So that's good to know. I need to keep that in mind. I need to check every pump now. See if it's functioning good. It's something I just haven't been doing. I need to do that. I probably got quite a few that have some pretty bad pumps on them, causing some problems. So we got, I'll call this one usable.